Let's go over some scores of the week. And I am seeing these for the first time with you guys. So I'm going to pull them up and share them on the screen as we go. Now, we run this thread over on the Facebook group every single Sunday so you can share your best score of the week. And you guys, it doesn't have to be a huge score. Remember, these are to inspire and motivate. Give us your backstory. Tell us why you bought it. Inspire. It's all good. We all get different stuff, and so it's good to see our variety. So thank you guys for being willing to share your... I keep looking at my hair in this camera, and it's driving me crazy, you guys. It's going to be one of those nights. All right. Let's see. Our first score comes from Kim and Steve Tucker, who are upstairs. And their item number is 15118573-3122. Now that did not go. Gosh darn it. Let me try that again. My computer is just like against me tonight. 15118573-3122. Let me pull that up. Look at it at the same time as you. I'll give you a little backstory as I pull that up, and then I'm gonna pull the screen over here. You should be able to see that now. Okay, so this is for the baseball fans. Purchased this classic leather Letterman's jacket. And those are really good keywords, and I don't see those in the thing. So I'm not sure. Is this a Letterman jacket or not? It's definitely a New York Yankees jacket with the big New York on the front. Bought it local Savers for $21. It was listed on December 9th for $149.95. And they accepted a best offer on January 28th of $100. So that's a profit of $79. $79. Great eye. You guys, jackets. Jackets do really well. Let me see if I can pull up some of these other pictures that you see. We're going into baseball season soon, too. It was leather. Yeah, this was a no-brainer at $20. I hope all of you that sell jackets would have picked this up. Can't tell what that says on there. Something Mirage. Oh, that's the brand. Okay. Genuine Merchandise Mirage. Got it. And it, oh, you guys see that? That's really important on these sports jackets. As you look, you see the baseball league. There we go. This little logo right here. Really important to know that it's officially licensed. Cool stuff. Cool stuff. Way to go. Nice, nice score. All right, let's see our next score. I'll come back on here for a minute and see while I type this in. This comes from Linda Gonzalez. She's one of my Tucson Appsters. And this is item number 31083094-3786. Let's pull this up. Ah, Villeroy and Bosch. Is it Bosch or Bach? I never know. Because it is German, after all. And you know, us Germans like to go Bach. Okay. Nice, nice score. Okay, I got to show you guys this one. Whoo! This is it Amapola or Amapola? Whatever that word is there. It's a footed cream soup bowl and saucer set of six. And let's see what her story is on this. She purchased a 55-piece set of Villeroy and Bosch dinnerware in the Ampola, I'll call it Ampola pattern, for $240 at her local Goodwill. That's a pretty big investment, right? So she already sold enough of the pieces to more than make her money back. And then on December 27th, she listed this set of six-footed cream soup bowls and saucers for the $345. Sold them on February 2nd for her full asking price. All right, way to go. So I don't see how many other pieces were already sold of this, Linda, but man, oh man, what a great job. Villeroy & Bosch, you guys, is one of those brands. Definitely, if you sell dinnerware and you come across this brand Don't be scared off by a big price, because that big price still might yield you a huge profit, as Linda is showing us here. I mean, this was just part of that 55-piece set. Keep that in mind. Man, that is awesome. Replacements has these two-piece sets for $79.95 each. I mean, that would be $479.70 from Replacements. So she set her price just about right there, you know, to beat them out. Sometimes I'll even match Replacements price. I don't let them scare me. In fact, I'll give you a good story. I have some bone plates. They're the Game Bird series. I had a buyer come in and actually tell me what the Replacements price was on the plates. I was asking the same as Replacements. They bought more than one, so I gave them a deal. But I came back at them, not at the price they wanted, with them telling me, well, Replacements has these for $34.95. I came back at $29.95 counter and reminded them. I said, yes, but they're going to charge you shipping on top of that as well. So keep that in mind. Replacements does charge some whopping shipping and handling. So you got that going for you too, especially when you're willing to do the free. Yep, yep, yep. So very nice job, Linda. Way to go. All right, looks like we might have a Valentine's score. Let me pull this one up. It's right around the corner, you guys, believe it or not. Hoo-hoo! I'm going to see Sawyer Brown. I'm so happy. Okay, I had to get that out there. I'm so jazzed. Got my tickets. I don't have a babysitter yet, though. And Grandma won't be here yet, darn it. Oh, yes, we definitely have a Valentine's score here. All right, let me pull this up for you guys to see. And we have a big old teddy bear, item number 2713-7202-6984. And this is from Kimberly Crawford, who likes to throw the millionaire over there on Facebook, because it brings her that good vibe, everybody calling her a millionaire. I love that, Kimberly. I think that's awesome. She purchased this 40-inch jumbo Valentine plush teddy bear at her local thrift store for just under $5. Yes, you guys, you can find these big old honking teddy bears for $5 or less. She's got all the words in her title: jumbo, giant, huge, large. Got it. Jumbo's a really good one, though. People really do search for jumbo. She sold it, she listed it on the 14th and sold it today for a best offer of $150, you guys. $150 for a $5 teddy bear. He looks like he scrunched up really easy, too, to fit into a big bag to ship. Wondering if that's how you shipped him, Kimberly. Good job getting him home and listed quick, too. That was very, very smart. Very smart. Love it, love it, love it. So yes, get that big stuff list. I mean, there's still people shopping for Valentine's this week and can get it in time. So if you've got that stuff, yep, yep, yep. I know these are selling at Walmart for, you know, like $30, $40. You could technically pick them up and flip them, but the problem is at this point, you could get stuck with them for a while. But here you go. Those that they're not squeamish about listing something and having it be a little long tail. What do you think Walmart's going to do on February 15th? Yeah, we're talking major clearance sale on this stuff. And I would be jumping on going and getting those half price. Half price. Or even more. They go more than half price. So if you can pick those up for, you know, $15, $20, go ahead and list them. I mean, worst that can happen is you hold on to it for a while, but turning it into $150, pretty good deal. Total clearance. Love clearance. All right. What is our next score? Ooh, I like this one. I like it. I like it a lot. Let me go over there and get this punched in. This is from Renee. Oh, Renee, I am going to mess up your last name so bad. Is it Mashak? Or Masat? I'm not even going to try. I'm just going to mess it up so bad. You'll have to tell me when I see you, hopefully in person one day. Anyway, she purchased this. Let me put it up here. It's item number 2311 4339 2460. Let me pull it up so I can show it to you. Very nice. We've talked about this before, you guys. This vintage household fixture stuff. Let me pull it up on the screen. Vintage household fixtures. People are redoing houses. They're restoring houses back to their original state. This is a 1950s Hall Mac vintage chrome revolving bathroom toothbrush cup soap holder. This is awesome. I love it. A dollar. It was a dollar at an estate sale, you guys. Oh my goodness. Yeah, I'm telling you, this is the kind of stuff that estate sales, they discount. They don't put much credibility into this stuff because this is not, you know, what they're in it for. They're in it for the antiques and the big bucks collectibles and, you know, the silver and the gold and all of that stuff. But fixtures like this, so she says the home belonged to a man that used to own his own tiling company. And there was great retro fixtures. I hope you got a bunch of them. Did you get a bunch of them, Renee? At a buck a piece, boy, I would have been grabbing them all. Very, very awesome. So it sold in 7 days, and 7 bids later, it sold for $76. $76. And just, Renee, so you know, people don't care if you charge shipping on those auctions. You can totally charge shipping on auctions. It will not scare your bidders away. Oh, there was only this one shoved in the bottom of a box. Darn. Oh, she also bought a complete set of lilac purple porcelain ceramic fixtures. Nice. Oh, I would totally get those listed. Those sound so cool. Totally. Yes, yes, yes. Awesome. Awesome. Awesome job. Good spot. All right. I'll come back to you for a minute. I'm starting to get the hang of, you know, pushing the buttons on when put me back on the camera, when the stuff's on the camera. You know, there's a big delay between what you guys see and what I'm saying. It's really kind of a weird thing to get used to. But I'm getting there. I'm getting there. All right. Our next one. Item number 11123753806. Let me pull this up. We're going on some more mid-century. You guys getting the idea? Mid-century stuff is hot, hot, hot. Holy smokes. I remember these. These were purchased. Let me show you. These were purchased at an antique store in Virginia while Kathy Johnston Goymarack was vacationing there this past summer. She paid $8 for the set. You guys can pick up these vintage glasses so cheap. So cheap. Oh my gosh, I see them in the thrift stores and at the auction, estate sales, and nobody wants them for some reason. But people want them online because she sold these for a best offer of $110. $110. Nice. Nice. And that way, you guys, you know, you take your vacations, you go do a little shopping, you can write it off, you can call it a business trip. Totally legit. Totally legit. Shop a little every day. Call it a business trip. Gotta love it. Gotta love it. All right, you guys, awesome scores.